Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. So a while back, I made a rather lighthearted video talking about annoying things that influencers do. And while that video was lighthearted and just poking fun, I was underlining some small issues that I find in the influencer world on social media. Today we're gonna be talking about heavier problems, problems that we should talk about more, but problems that people often don't feel comfortable talking about. I myself am a little bit nervous talking about this just because I really want to come in from the right direction just so my motives here are not misinterpreted. I think we can all agree that social media can be great, and I appreciate social media for the sole fact that not only can you build a career by just having an Instagram and being a talented person or having something to offer or having a YouTube, but you can build a career doing something that you genuinely love and are interested in, and that to me is very inspirational. That motivates me, and I think that that is honestly one of the best things to have happened. This being said, if there's something good, there's gonna be something bad. And there are plenty of things that I see wrong with social media. The thing is, a specific case came to my attention, and it highlighted how cutthroat and how disgusting some people will act to maintain their social media persona, their perceived social status, their image on the internet, whatever you want to call it. Now, I think as a 90s kid, and one of the things I heard the most from my mom was to be careful of people on the internet and that you never know who you're dealing with. This is now more relevant than ever with programs like Photoshop, where you can alter yourself entirely. It's very easy to change what you look like, and when it's easy to change what you look like, it's also easy to change how you are perceived by other people. AKA, you can be one thing in person and a completely different thing online, and no one's ever gonna know unless they meet you in person. I know that a lot of the times I see comments, and I've received comments myself that say some of these things, saying, you know, like, goals, or mom, or oh my god, I wish I looked like you, I wish I had your body, I wish I, whatever, you know? And I think that there are two distinct mentalities people can have when they're commenting on a person's social media. When you're commenting on a person's social media, there's such a thing as saying, oh my god, goals, but still being a skeptic inside and saying, hey, I like what I've seen of this person so far, but I actually don't know what this person is like. So as much as I want them to be a good person and I want them to be what I think they are, I also realize that they might be completely different. The issue is that there's also this mentality that is like, I know who they are, they're exactly this, this, and this, I know what this person is, even if you've only seen pictures or maybe 10-minute videos on YouTube of them. And the problem is, these people with a second mentality will go to all lengths to defend a person that they do not know and that might not deserve their defense. So, let's get into the story now. So, there is a man called Edwin. He made a video defending his girlfriend, Mina, from harassment, abusive behavior, illegal action that this Instagrammer called Dasha has taken towards Mina. There are two videos. One is around 30 minutes, and the other one is approximately 51 minutes, both published by Edwin, in which he shows screenshots and proof that Dasha has in fact been slandering and generally just trying to get in the way of Mina's life in one way or another, whether it was in terms of work opportunities or kind of ruining her image with other influencers. It was just the kind of stick in the mud where it's everywhere you turn, it seems like that person's trying to get in the way. I actually was following Dasha before I knew about any of this stuff, and I still am now, just so I can show you what her page looks exactly like the day I'm filming this. I'll insert some clips of Edwin here and there just so I don't have to paraphrase him or, you know, use words that he might not be using. But I do think that it's important for me to list out a couple of things that Dasha has done to highlight how severe it can get in the world of social media influencers. And now I know everyone on the other side of this lens is probably like, okay, Julia, we already know people are catty, people are bitchy, people are whatever. Yes. Yes, that's all inevitably true. The thing is, this to me was an extreme that I hadn't heard of or seen before. So I'm bringing you this video not only to bring awareness to Mina and Edwin's story and to bring awareness to the type of person that Dasha is, but also as a reminder to all of us, myself included, that we don't know who we're dealing with. So when we see these internet wars go down between influencers, between beauty gurus, between whoever, let us not assume we know anyone, and let us always wait to see the proof before we jump on any bandwagon and go hating on people, because sometimes people with a bigger following, like Dasha, have fans that are so dead set in believing everything that she portrays herself as that they end up hating on Mina and Edwin, when in reality, they're not only in the wrong, but severely, severely misguided in what they're trying to do. And I'm not blaming anyone for falling for someone's tricks or for falling for someone's image, because that happens to everyone. It's just a question of finding a healthy level of cynicism. So here I'm going to list a couple of the things that Dasha has done to Mina, essentially, and then kind of Edwin in consequence too. So there are these forums online, gossip forums, where you can talk about problematic influencers, YouTubers, whatever. And I know that most of them have a policy that you cannot post about yourself in third person and you can't impersonate someone else, which in this particular situation go together. So on one of these forums, Dasha had been posting as someone else and talking to herself as someone else, so kind of having a conversation with herself 142 times.
A couple weeks go by and the website's administrator is able to identify Dasha for posting 142 posts on the thread, all defending herself in third person and talking about herself and insulting me and insulting Mina most of all. And by the way, the administrators of the website added a little signature to every single one of her posts. And the signature is a caricature of Dasha and how they imagine her posting on the thread.
That is 142 posts. And those 142 posts, in my point of view, were there to stir the pot. Another thing she did, which was illegal, was that she took photos from Mina's phone and posted them on the internet without her consent. These were nude photos.
One of Dasha's fans was commenting on Mina's Instagram, and she was saying that she didn't believe that Dasha would post a picture of Mina's passport or the naked pictures of her, and that Mina's iCloud could have been hacked. First of all, in order for your iCloud to be hacked, you have to use the service, which Mina doesn't. So in case you don't know, iCloud is a monthly subscription service by Apple that allows you to save and store all your phone data into an online server. Alternatively, you can just store and save all your data onto your phone and nobody can access it unless, of course, they have access to your phone. Which again, Dasha admitted in the past to going through Mina's phone and deleting her Instagram.
That in itself, to me, is not only something of malevolent and disgusting, but it just really makes me question having any respect, you know, like there's such a thing as being catty, there's such a thing as being petty, and then there's such a thing as putting out revenge porn. I don't understand. She also sent her followers to hate on both Mina and Edwin, and in Edwin's video, one of these followers admits that this is a reality. So this is not assumption, presumption, or just me guessing and pulling it out of my ass. She actually had people tasked with going to hate on these two people who wanted nothing to do with Dasha.
I had to delay the video for about a day because I received some messages from someone that I totally did not expect to hear from. This is one of Dasha's former fans and one of her most notable minions. And we called her, amongst other Dasha fans, minions because they would literally do anything that Dasha would say at the snap of a finger. Like they were always harassing me and Mina, making memes, making accounts, just to continue harassing us. So naturally, I ignored her messages until I saw one of her Snapchats requesting that I open them. I recently began to realize that she had been manipulating me by acting like I was important to her, calling me a good friend, etc., when she literally just used me to send you and Mina hate. She'd tell me word for word what to tweet and comment. She would ask me to create content to get back at you both. I only realized all this when she pretty much entirely cut me off for wanting to remain neutral, and it made me feel hella shitty.
In another instance, Dasha said that she spoke ill of Mina to a photographer or a brand, and wanted to portray Mina as badly as possible in order to hinder future job possibilities. I think that's where you see that all of this is a chase to maintain a certain perceived social position. And I'll explain what I mean by that in a second.
When the drama was still active, one of my viewers messaged you to get your side of the story, and then you told them that you were gonna make sure your photographers thought of Mina in a negative way. You said, "I wanted to fly her out because she apologized to me, because she has told me about how bad England and her parents are." Again, you were well aware she was coming from a very crappy situation, and I could relate to her. I saw a younger, more inexperienced version of myself in her, and I wanted to help her. Wanted to hook her up with an agency and my photographers, which now all know about her in a negative way, which I made sure of.
Finally, and this was one of the most shocking things to me, specifically because I followed some of these other influencers, it came to light that Dasha had a group chat with a bunch of other influencers. And if you ever followed Dasha, you would have seen that in her Instagram stories, she'd often shout people out. I'm guessing that a lot of those influencers that she shouts out, almost always the same ones, were in that group chat. There was a screenshot and I saw two main people that I was following in that group chat. And you actually see that Dasha victimizes herself and turns around the whole story. So it's actually Mina who is an abusive and toxic person. And she's the one who has been doing all these evil things to Dasha.
And something that you probably agree on as well is that you're a very good networker, you know, which is not a bad thing, but you're so good at networking that you even have a group chat with other big Instagram influencers with hundreds of thousands of followers. And how do you use your influence? To lie to them about Mina and make yourself a victim of everything you've done to her. I'm gonna be showing you some screenshots of a group chat that Dasha is in with other big social media influencers and show you the way Dasha talks about herself and the way she talks about Mina. So the conversation starts out with Cleo saying that someone was copying her, and Dasha immediately jumps in to relate and says, "Wait, I'll unfollow her. That sucks, dude. I actually know exactly what it's like because I have someone like that too who, in addition to copying me, tried to make it look like it's the other way around, and she's a total psychopath." Cleo says, "Who? I'm gonna block her stupid ass." It's a long story. Mina XX Bell. Spill tea, please. She tried breaking into my house and stole my looks and made YouTube videos and lied. She's my boyfriend's ex and tried to get back with him, made fake fan accounts for herself and bought followers. Cleo Lazuli says, "Never mind, I wasn't even following her. I block." Now, okay, fun little tidbit. She actually was following Mina before this, and she did not block her, but she did unfollow her. Dasha says, "It's a very long story which made me suicidal, actually." Again, this is new, and I don't know, it doesn't sit well with me that after everything you put us through, you wanna play the suicidal victim now. You have no idea how much mental anguish you caused me last year. And you know, also Mina, you didn't quite make her suicidal, but what you did to me is completely, it's so ridiculous to see you type this and try to make yourself the victim, because it was extremely difficult at the time, you know, having people humiliate me constantly, and if I want to express myself about how I'm feeling, people just think I'm doing it for attention, for the joke. It's like, this is something that I've been doing from the beginning. Just because it concerns another social media influencer that will react 20 times per one tweet that I make, it doesn't mean that I'm doing it to poke at her or anything. Just because I'm upset and expressing myself as a direct result of someone harassing me, it doesn't mean that, you know. So like, for the past like year and a half, I feel like I haven't been able to live stream as much, I haven't been able to tweet as much, and I wish that I seeked therapy and stuff sooner, because I actually like talked to my therapist the other day and I told her, like, wow, it felt so good to let that out, because in another session, I wasn't able to express myself because I've always felt so ashamed of just sharing that story, because I feel like people are just sick of me and people insult me when I even open up about myself, you know? And I don't want to feel that way anymore, you know? I want to keep living my life transparently like I always have. And a lot of stuff she said about me and Mina, the lies, the insults, I have documented, so I can back it all up. I can back it all up if somebody doesn't believe it and they've seen the other two videos, they still don't believe it. I have hundreds of screenshots of what she's done. And even though I have expressed how depressed I was last year, trust me, I did not express it even the slightest to the extent of how horrible I felt. And that's because of feeling so invalidated. And I can already predict that there's gonna be backlash of people saying that it's all for views or some bullshit, man. Like, it doesn't matter what I say online, you know. Just because I put an ad on a dramatic video, people will say I'm milking it or whatever, what I feel is not true. And I don't give a shit. I actually just don't give a shit. If she does try to excuse her sort of feeling depressed or suicidal as an excuse to all of the harassment she's put us through and just lie about the shit she's put us through, then that'll just be the most outrageous things, you know. Like, sorry for ranting. I just really wanted to get that off my chest because I can't understand how she is okay with saying all this stuff. Like, literally everything that she's done and everything that she's made other people feel, suddenly it's turned around and, you know, she's the victim and people are attacking her. It baffles my mind. The conversation wraps up with Cleo Lazuli saying, "What? I'll kill her. That's lame. She's lame." And Yella Bambi adds in a little, "Gross."
So when I say that this to me seemed like a way to secure a social position or a perceived social position, in Edwin's video, it was stated that Dasha said that she wanted to ruin Mina and that she never really wanted to be friends with her.
Dasha, why can't you give it a rest? You reached out to Mina and it was really confusing because you would always be talking shit about Mina and when we would question you, me, Sierra, and Sam, Sam's old, Sierra's old roommate, you would say, "Oh, I'm only pretending to be her friend so I could destroy her." And Sierra even repeated this to a mutual friend who already confirmed it in another video. You only talked to Mina so you could destroy her. You reached out to her. She never reached out to you. And Kate said, "Yeah, she said she was pretending to be her friend so she could destroy her." I said, "Thanks. I just wanted to type it so Mina could read it and know that it wasn't just once that she said it. Because she didn't just say it to me once and to Sam once. She said it very many times."
Now, from the get-go, we have insecurity. Because why would you want to ruin someone? Someone who hasn't reached out to you, someone who has nothing to do with you, someone who isn't trying to come in on your territory or anything, someone who's just doing their own thing, living their own life. But you want to ruin it. And you not only want to ruin it, you want to get close to them so you can ruin it. Essentially, the story began when Dasha asked her boyfriend to fly out Mina because Mina is in the UK. But imagine going to the length of wanting to ruin another influencer so much that you get your boyfriend to fly them over. You get them to essentially live with you. You go through their phone, you delete things, you emotionally toy with them, you manipulate them, and then you have the gall to turn around and say, "Oh, I didn't do anything, it was her who was toxic to me the whole time." While this story isn't a story of life and death, and some of you might say that I'm taking this like far too seriously, what I am saying is that the internet is a scary place, and that sounds really cheesy and really stupid, but the reality is that some of the people who you might be calling your favorites right now are doing shit like this. And the reason that I'm talking about it is because I don't want anyone who does shit like this to get away with it for 1 second, because that's not how you operate. That's not how you treat other people. And that's not how an adult acts towards another adult. If you have a problem, you can talk about it. If you can't get through your own problems, you leave, you separate, you end the story. You don't go on to harass, you don't go on to continuously poke and poke and poke at someone, especially considering that that hurts people's mental health, okay? I don't know in what kind of mental health you have to be that kind of toxic person, but it's worth talking about for the simple reason that anyone could be on the receiving end of behavior like Dasha's. Anyone could be receiving that kind of behavior, and no one talking about it is what lets people get away with it. So really my bottom line here is to bring attention to Edwin and Mina's story, but more than that, to just continue to keep a level of skepticism on the internet, where I think people have become a little bit too comfortable running from side to side, defending someone or defending the other. And you might be saying, "Hey, well, Julia, well, why are you on the side of Edwin and Mina?" And I can say that there is proof. I have seen the evidence. I believe what I have seen because I have been shown something. Something that says, "Hey, there was foul play here, and the behavior of this other person wasn't okay." Anyways, I know this was a different video. I hope that I wasn't too much of a shit show. I've honestly tried to keep it as organized as possible, but like I said, this isn't my main gig, let's say. So hopefully I presented it to you in a way that makes sense to you and in a way that you can relate. Please let me know what you think about, you know, like this dark side of social media influencers. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you to my patrons as always. I won't be putting fan art today to go with this video. It just doesn't seem quite appropriate, but I'll see you next time.